So how do you make money while you're out flying your drone without your Part 107 license? Good morning, everybody. I'm out here with my new Bounty Hunter Time Ranger metal detector. Just got it yesterday. I've zipped through the manual. It's a pretty inclusive manual. There's a lot of features and functions available on this thing. But I got maybe, 8% of what it has because I just burned right through it. Because what I want to do today with my massive excavating tool is use it in conjunction with the singly, I've got it upside down, singly pointer that'll dig in the hole and narrow things down for me to see if I can find a quarter. So this is going to be a demonstration, day one, of what this thing might be able to do if an idiot who doesn't know or anything just pushes the button and sees if he can find a quarter. So let's see what it'll do for me. Okay, so it zoomed in and it said there was some zinc. And I was looking at the little range indicator. And with the pointer, I was just able to dig this little bitty hole. It's 1.5 inches deep. We found a 1983 penny. Hey, if all I have to do is dig a little hole that tiny to find my penny, this is fine. I said it was a nickel. Right in that little bitty hole. I mean, that's just a little bitty hole. But it was a pull tab. I'll learn. But boy, it sure did find it. So I just got back home from the park. I was gone about an hour. And after an hour, I had 7 pull tabs and 2 pennies. I had this set up. Oh, it's probably going to go crazy in here. But I had it set up in program 1. That's just the default setting that it starts at. But I had sensitivity down to 3. Just to play with it. And what I found out was pretty cool. I would go along and I would hit a target, do my X, and then I would take a look with my pointer after I did. Well, you have to pull it away from the target a little bit and then hit all metal smart track, and it'll do a tone, and where the tone's the loudest is where the circle, yeah, is where the inner circle of the coil would be. I don't know why it's doing all that. And then I take the pointer and just point at that little area, and every single time this thing went off. That told me that the target was no more than about 2 inches deep. And every single time, the hole was no bigger than that big around, that deep. And for my first go, that's what I was looking for, just to see what this thing could sniff out, and it did. I was very impressed. So I still don't know hardly anything about it, but it found it, and it found it right at 2 inches deep, because I had my massive excavation tool, which I think I left in the car, my butter knife. So I was really prepared for some heavy duty treasure hunting for sure. Came away with a good experience. Now I'm gonna read the book a little bit more and see what more I can do. And so, ladies and gentlemen, I can go fly my drone, land it, go find money, and make money while out flying my drone without the Part 107.